This is the win-loss record for both teams. Plavins and Tocs, they've fought their way through, battled hard, and got some great upset results along the way. For Qatar, it was pretty much plain sailing. They dropped one set, and that was only in against the USA, Phil Dahlhauser and his partner, Lucena. And for Plavins and Tocs, well, it was a topsy-turvy game. They just gutsed it out, got the results they needed, and found themselves in with a chance of going to the final, but still in with a chance here of getting a medal. But it's not going to be easy. This is going to be a tough one.
It's a mix of two different types of players and teams here, with the team from Qatar really dynamic, in a lot of good form, coming off three finals in Cancun with one of those as a victory. Really, in the last 2020 and 2021, have been there and thereabouts, which is why they're the number three seeds. And the Latvians coming through the qualification process in the Continental Cup stages to get here in the Olympic Games. And also then in Martins Plavins, one of the most tenacious, wily characters you'll see, with years of experience. He's got a bronze medal from 2012. He'll be looking to what he could do backcourt, but against Cherif at the net with huge block, and then the fast backcourt reading of the game of Ahmed Tijan. This Latvian duo have really got to work hard, and it's a fairly new partnership still within the Latvian team, with Tocs coming in on blocking duties for Martins Plavins as well.
One thing's for sure, they'll be relying on that experience of Plavins. As you mentioned, he's such an experienced campaigner, played in Beijing, played in London, didn't qualify for Rio, is here now, and they will not give this up. They won't give it in, but they're just going to kind of, the way they go about it as well, there's just like that, nonchalant, they kind of wander, they conserve so much energy when they're not playing.
With Latvia, you need to expect the unexpected as well. You're going to have a huge block in Cherif at the net. He's on 24 block kills already in this competition. As soon as Plavins goes up against him, he's going to have to get creative, which he can do, and he uses the ball really well.
Shiokaze Park in Tokyo Bay, the reclaimed part of the bay to make this. It's an incredible arena. We are expecting an incredible match. Warm up over. Players to their seats. We'll have the introduction of the referees.
Gentlemen, it is almost time for this men's bronze medal match. But as always, we love to welcome to Stadium Court our officials. They stand front and center, and we welcome then our first referee. Congratulations on your appointment, sir, from the United States of America, Mr. Brig Beatty.
And it will be. It is a special moment for Brig Beatty, getting to referee a medal match at the Olympic Games, and so too for Roman Pristavakin from Russia.
Congratulations to you, sir, second referee from the Russian Olympic Committee. Please welcome Roman Pristavakin.
Just like the players, there'll be a mixture of nerves and excitement for the referees. We'll know if they've had a good game because we won't.
Tokyo 2020 Beach Volleyball Olympic Tournament. So, let's introduce the players. The Nashi 3rd Ketesen, first of all, Latvia team, 190cm, Olympic 3rd time.
We welcome the athletes now to Stadium Court for this men's bronze medal match. Athlete number one from Latvia is an F5VB Defensive Player of the Year. He now becomes a three-time Olympian as a London bronze medal to his name, Martins Plavins.
36 years of age from Riga,
1m90.
And his partner is an F5VB World Tour gold medalist, 2019 Latvian Beach Volleyball Player of the Year. And in the bronze medal match in his first Olympics, please welcome Edgars.
Edgars Tocs, 32 years of age, from Madonna.
And their opponents from Qatar. Our first athlete is a two-time Asian champion. He is in his second Olympics, easily one of the most excitable players in the world, Cherif. Yunus!
The Cherif from Dakar, Senegal, lives in Doha, 1m95.
And his partner, a two-time FIVB World Tour gold medalist, Asian Games champion, first-time Olympian, out of Doha, Qatar, Ahmed Tijan!
Ahmed Tijan, 26 years of age, born in Banjul, Gambia. What a moment for these two. They've dreamt of being in the Olympics. And there they might even make the dream of a medal a reality.
Please be up.
Time for the national anthems.
For the national anthems. Firstly, the national anthem of Latvia.
Latvia 国歌の演奏です.
Now please remain upstanding for the national anthem of Qatar.
続いてカタール国歌の演奏です。
Always a special moment to be representing your country, and even more special to have your anthem played out in front of you. This one is about to get underway. Players just making a few last-minute adjustments, getting those glasses clean. Final exchange of pleasantries, and we'll be underway. It's Latvia in lime green serving, Qatar in maroon receiving for this men's bronze medal match from the Tokyo 2020 Summer Olympic Games. Oh, what a start for Latvia!
Straight away, Tocs asserts his dominance of the net with a huge kill block, his 11th of the competition so far.
Latvia to serve again. An incredible start. Nice finish. Now that's more like it. That's what we expect from Qatar.
Latvia switching up this time, choosing to go to Cherif. Now, one thing with this team, they do move the ball really well, and they're going to make Tocs work hard. He's got that first kill block in, but he's got to work really hard to contain these two.
That's such good play. One of the things that we're going to see, and a good example of that there, is the ability for teams to tidy up. Bad pass, players running all the way over the other side of the court, and then they're still able to put it in a place where they can get that and make the side out.
Cherif sticking to the left-hand side, taking the line, giving the options for Plavins to go cross-court.
Where's the moment? Yes, good dig. Good up. Another chance for Latvia. This will have to come over. The block counts as a touch on the beach, and that was really tricky, having to jump back, the angle just running away.
Best option he had there was that cross-court shot. They do have this left-right hand combination as well, which works really well together. Tijan, fantastic covering backcourt. Those that have seen Ahmed Tijan play in the past know how much and how quick he reads this game.
Cherif once again tasked with side out. And he's done that. Well, he hits the ball so hard from such a height. It's really good to watch.
Tocs is going to have to work extra hard also on disguising where he's going to cover, take on that block as well. You see him reaching over. Easy options without too much of a press over the net for Cherif to wipe off.
That's well played.
That's the experience in Plavins. You watch as soon as that ball goes up from Tocs. He has a quick glance down just to check. But he's played that shot thousands of times.
Yes. Another chance for Qatar. Goodness me, that's like a jumping indoors. What's all that about?
Incredible swing. But great work there also by Ahmed Tijan, almost faking that he's going to go over on two. Making Tocs have a quick look. Then it's that flat set out wide. Just huge leap. Incredible.
It's difficult enough for us mere mortals to walk on the sand, let alone do what these guys are doing, to run and jump and everything else that goes with it. Latvia, still though, up by one at the moment. First side switch, Qatar round to the other side. Oh, that's a great serve, an ace serve to level things up.
Tijan. Ahmed Tijan there, going to Plavins. Plavins just got his body behind it, but just snatching away, moving his arms at the last moment.
Play. Both sides are getting some good touches in the block, actually. They're squeezing quite well, aren't they? It's not a big court to go at for either team.
They've just been getting a feel for each other as well. They've only played three times against each other, so they're still been working each other out a little bit here in the early stage of this bronze medal match.
That's well played. It is an option to go over on two. Three touches is the most you can have. Doesn't mean to say you actually have to have them.
Both these two use this two-ball attack really well and have used it a lot in the competition so far. So the block's got to be really on point here.
No! The tactics are pretty evident at the moment as to which player is being served out for both sides. Plavins has got a lot of work to do for Latvia. Likewise, Cherif is the player tasked with getting the side out for Qatar, and he does it so well.
Latvia are going to have to start to work on where they place Cherif to move him further out wide to stop him coming inside. As soon as he gets inside with that left hand, he's then got so many options where to go. And with that high hitting action he's got.
Line block called and line block called, both sides. Cherif, that means the blocker will take away the line if he can, and defender's going to shuffle into the cross court. But he didn't make any movement at all then, Ahmed. He got caught behind the block.
He normally reads it well. He doesn't want to obviously sell himself too early, as Plavins has a quick look. You're right, he's directly behind the block there. Nice tight angle by Plavins as well.
Really good swing again. This makes you wonder, doesn't it? They're going after Cherif, he's doing that, and they're not going after Ahmed because he's even better.
Yeah, hit the percentages for Ahmed is in the high 60s in this competition. So they're going to be targeting Cherif a little bit more. They might actually just have to switch up a little bit or change the way that they bring that serve in and put the pressure on him a little bit more that way.
Ahmed knows that he will get served on at some point because the team of Latvia will just want to make sure that he is paying attention. He doesn't get into that stepping into set mode the whole time. Well, that looked more in than out, but it's been given out. It might be a challenge. It might just be accepted. It's going to be accepted. He's so good at just moving it around the block. Great control level he has.
It's that vision, it's that look he does. I mentioned it earlier. But they just, you have a quick look down and then just how he executes those little shots left and right.
A huge part of the beach volleyball skill level you need to have is your ability to take your eye off the ball, see where the block is, see where the defender is, and then reconnect with the ball to play your shot. That's not easy. These players do it all time and time again and make it look easy.
Cherif watching that ball come over his shoulder on that left hand. Gets a touch off the hand and then rolls across the tape. Both the players having a quick look. Tocs hoping for it to drop in.
Line blocks called again, and they're going after Plavins. The little waggle of the finger to show where he wants the ball to be served.
Yes! Yes!
Great block. It's interesting watching Cherif's block. He's really close to the net. His hands are under the net to start with. Then he has to come back out, go up and go over the top. How he makes it work, I don't know. It's not easy to do. That's huge. I think actually he could be an even better blocker if he just took a half a step off the net so he could go straight up and straight across. He could get even further and even quicker because he's having to go and then press. But that was great.
There are so many different styles of blocks. So, for example, Moll from the Volley Vikings, he stays down low, out of eyesight, then comes up. Stuart Noski is just over all the time. Just has a big brick wall up there.
Qatar are proving to be a brick wall at the moment at the net. Another point for them, that one from the ace, from the serving line. That's always difficult. When you're a defender like that, it comes off the block. It could go either way. The important thing is, though, for the defender is not to get frustrated by that.
Yeah, and in this game, especially with it, they both played the two ball really well, it's whether that blocking can get that touch on it. As soon as any deflection is there, as you said, that court is 8 metres wide, it's really hard to change direction and get that far across.
Technical timeout, Qatar leading. That'll be with some work to do.
So keep going there. So that is our cover. Of course, you go very high.
What a tournament for Triborne, coming in at the last minute, finding himself top of the stats for attacks. Cherif may well move up a little bit further come the end of this one.
So Cherif and Ahmed will be happy how they've turned that around at the technical timeout, being down by a couple of points early on at the very start of this set. They put the pressure on Plavins on this serve.
Tocs with it, he'll scurry to the net to make a block if he can. But he gets a touch. But it's a point for Qatar.
Nice side out on the right-hand side. That left hand hits on the right-hand side. The whole court just opens up for him.
Get the feeling that actually Tocs just wants to be half a step inside and get that left hand of his right into the head of Cherif, which means he can try and stop him hitting the line as well. Yeah! There's no stopping Cherif at the net in his blocking. That's another quality block.
On his block so far today, in the competition so far, sorry, he's on 27 kill blocks now with that one. And he is, it's his timing as well. Yes, he's got different techniques with us, but it's that timing he has just to get that finish on there and the press down.
He's very, very quick out of the sand, and he's right into that ball. I mean, by the time it's being hit, he's only inches away from it, so there's no angles, are there? It's incredible.
It's that reach over that net as well. It just cuts out so much options that Plavins has. So when they do have that ball tight on the net, Plavins has to work extra hard to be able to regenerate it or get the ball back into play.
You get the feeling that Plavins is going to, if he can jump, but he's then got to accelerate and change his rhythm and go slightly quicker so he can get the shot away before the block can close, because there's definitely two movements from Cherif. He goes up and then he presses.
And this is where those little cut shots that he's played early on in the game so far have come in really, really handy as well.
Cherif with the serve. Plavins the target again. Yes. Good self-recovery. There's a real chance here now. For Qatar. Yeah. Line was the call, but he didn't want to play any roll shots.
Ahmed was feeling left out there because he's not had many swings recently, so I'm open my shoulder up here. There we see Plavins at the first attack, actually going into the block. And actually using that, and as you said, a good recovery. But that's his only option, to keep the ball alive.
Tomahawk. Chicken wing. And an unforced error. Qatar take the point. That chicken wing providing a recipe for success here for Qatar, it would seem. Help. That's well played, getting the pokey, get a little bit of help from the net. Good up, that's unlucky. Oh, do you know what? That was such a great pick, and Cherif's gone, yeah, that's not coming. Oh, it was right by my feet.
Excellent work by Tocs as well, because obviously he had the touch at the net, which was almost beaten by Cherif there, and then just had the whereabouts just to play that ball over, and we know how quick Ahmed is, that it's got to be really tight on the line there to beat him.
That's good up, really good play. Such a shame. Just those little things now not quite clicking for Latvia. Qatar are racing away with this first set.
All that hard work to get there. And then as he's falling away, trying to get the angling option to attack, can't get his hand over it enough. Ahmed quite happy to watch that ball just sail along.
It's shots in the city for Plavins. He's not going to go up and swing on hardly anything. He's just going to go up, isn't he? And then last minute, make changes.
It was a great delay there. We saw Cherif go across to Cherif's right-hand side. His arms just swinging wide. And as soon as that happened, Plavins' hand just came around the ball and easy options. We say it's easy options, but that's still a hard shot to execute, to drop it in court. Not enough power on it and it stays on your side of the net. You look a little bit silly. Too much on it, and it's straight into Ahmed's arms, and they've got a free attack.
Well, on those little tight angles like that, too much on it, and it's out of court. You've got to be so precise when you are chipping the ball around the block. Oh, one of the reasons the court was made smaller, it used to be the same size as indoors, 9x9. It was reduced to this size to make that happen, so that the ball was being bounced, and no more of those roll shots that no one could get anywhere near. Let's have the bouncers that no one can get anywhere near.
Might be looking for a 4x4 court instead of an 8x8 if he's going to start putting the ball there.
That's well played. He's got a really good arm, really strong shoulder, actually, because it doesn't open up, does he? He's up straight, and he's just literally forcing his arm through the ball.
There we see Cherif staying straight on that line. So he's still got a lot of angle to come across on his left on his left-hand side for Plavins to use that space well.
Getting ever closer to this first set now. 19-12, 21 points is the winning score to get to. If we get a 20-all, we keep going until someone gets two clear. But that's not looking like it's going to happen at the moment.
Tocs getting the reach there, just not getting the press on the block, so it's flat, so it's going to be easy pickings for the wipe-off.
Well played. No carry called against Qatar. Latvia with another chance. And that's the level of what Qatar are doing, that Plavins trying to move that away from the pair of them, but trying to be too precise.
So Latvia just needing to slow down those errors. Even if it's just getting the boys from Qatar to actually kill the ball themselves, all the errors they're creating themselves, making it hard work.
It's got even harder now because that ace gives Qatar the set 21-12. What a start for Ahmed and Cherif. They lead by one set to nothing over Latvia.
Let's have a quick look at the set one stats then. 21-12. Pressure on the serve with the aces as well, dropping down the center, that corridor of uncertainty, that panic channel. A dominant performance by Qatar.
Set two underway, Qatar serving. Latvia looking for side out. Qatar leading by one set to nothing in this best of three bronze medal match. Nice start. Tidy side out from Plavins.
That does his confidence a world of good. Come through a really tough pool, taking on some of the big names in the game, beating Alisson and Alvaro also to get themselves here. They're losing to the Vikings.
That's well played by Tocs, that one coming up, and he just showed he's the king of ping with that one. Little change up, Latvia going after Ahmed. That'll do nicely. 3-0 for Latvia.
Ahmed, just have a quick look at the line there.
It's still there where it was earlier. Yeah.
And the ball mark's still on the outside of the line. He was just having a double check, then comes back.
Well, it's been given as out.
Cherif's seen something, though. Now, they have got challenges available.
For those of you wondering about that, maybe what the challenge system is, the players can have unlimited challenges to certain decisions. Ball in out being one of them, net touch, block touch. Now it's been given as out. Now the sand has splashed onto the line, but the sand splashing on the line isn't the same as the ball hitting the line. Oh, that's hit it. That's definitely caught it.
Great challenge. There when that ball compresses, this the beach volleyball is 30% less filled with air or less. Compressed, what's the word I'm trying to think of there? I can't think of it now, it's landed on the line.
It certainly squidges a bit more or a bit less, depending
it
on how you look at it.
It squidges more, yes, you're absolutely right. Less than an indoor ball, so as it lands on the sand there, it doesn't compress quite as much.
Qatar on the board with their first point.
Yes, you are! 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3-1, 3
side out achieved. Ahmed getting an opportunity to get some rhythm now. See how high he gets. That net is 2.43 meters. Most of you wondering, it's the same height as the crossbar in soccer or football, 8 foot. And these guys getting their numbers above it at times. So it's a great dig on. It will stay in play.
Incredible defense. A big chance for Latvia there with a big power swing cross. Ahmed's chest is up to it. He just watches that ball sail over.
This is a flex your pecs time. Keep it in play.
Who needs three touches?
First side switch. The team's change ends on multiples of 7 points, so that there's no advantage to be had from where the sun's shining, where the wind might be blowing from during the course of a set. Well played.
Fantastic angle there, as you see, around the side of the court. So tight to the net. There's hands coming over as well, just make it extra hard. Perfect placement.
Great touch. And again. Oh, good up from Ahmed. Chance now for Qatar. Well taken. What a rally that was.
It's got it all there. Fantastic work on the defense. Big block. Tocs working really hard at the net. Tap man again. Ahmed getting some air time. For opening that arm up. You see, Tocs not get the press on there, but also leaning across his right hand side, losing a lot of height.
Cherif with the serve. Yes! Nice block from Cherif. It's getting a little bit tetchy for Latvia at the minute. Plavins not happy with Tocs, but it was Plavins who's put the ball in the block, not Tocs.
That'd be a little bit tight in their play as well. That's right, that line shot there, you'd normally expect Plavins to hit through that or use it off the block, which he was going for, but he hasn't got enough edge on it. But when it's working well and Cherif is blocking like he is, he's going to have that outside hand turning in to make sure that any touch does come on it, it is going to come back into court.
It's a strange game in that, so for Plavins, who's so used to playing those shots and getting cuts and chipping around the block, sometimes when there is an opportunity to actually swing on the ball, you've actually got to almost tell yourself to go and hit it because you're so used to doing the chips and the little touches around the block.
We've seen that with Ahmed in this second set as well. He's had a couple where he's done those little pokies over, then suddenly when he gets his arm open on there, it's a kill every time.
One of the differences between indoor volleyball and beach volleyball, for those of you wondering, you're not allowed to tip the ball on the beach. You can't go up and just move it around, manipulate it with your hand like you can indoors. You have to use the very, very ends of your fingers, or you have to use your knuckles, the pokey as it's known, and you'll see the players bend their fingers and make like what looks like a spaghetti separator, but play it off the top of their finger, of their knuckles to get the ball over. That's well played for a side out for Latvia.
Kind of switching that play up there as well. That's making Cherif move on that block. And as he's sailing across, he then goes the opposite way across his body.
Well played. That's past the block and inside the defence. That's an excellent swing from Ahmed.
Yeah, straight down the centre. Tocs giving him the options. As you see him crouching down low. Reaching up to the start on the right hand side, then moving across, but couldn't adjust quick enough.
All square at the moment. Latvia hanging in there in this set, and now move in front. It is a must win set for them.
This time they go down the options of targeting Tocs. He's able to get the swing down the line.
touch. Oh, it's so difficult. The ball spinning off the block like that, and it, when it touches the hand, it's then carried that spin and just moved away from where the blocker was.
Once they set themselves in that defence backcourt, any deflection, they've got to really quickly react. It came close enough to him, but just that one arm out, it looks, in slow motion, looks like he's got loads of time, but in reality, not so.
Generally, the ball's got a top spin on it, and also a lot of right-handers put a certain spin on the ball, so when you get a left-hander, it's a different spin, you have to deal with it differently, and when that ball come off the block like it did, and with one hand, very difficult to control. Oh, that's nice. That's one that's hit. Good angle.
He's obviously not the tallest on the court here at 190, but that high snap as well as the wrist there. It's not a full arm swing, it's just that wrist coming through it.
Got to show the wrist snap.
Let's go! Nice ball!
The line was the call, but that's just a suggestion.
Just like a recipe, for guidance. Wasn't the cleanest hit, as you can hear the sound of it, as he just gets his hand around the outside of the ball, but he knew exactly where he was going with that.
Line block signalled again by Cherif. It's been the pattern for Qatar in this match. Good chase, oh, well played. Oh, goodness me. That's off the block, is it? Well, that was an incredible, that's really good sporting spirit being shown by Cherif. He said, yeah, I touched it.
After all that effort, Cherif going all the way out, almost having to sit down in his own little box. A great chase down. It's those kind of points where you see that, where you kind of, Latvia know that they've done all that work, they've still got to make sure they close the point out if they're forcing Qatar to do that much defending.
Oh, good block.
This time, Tocs gets the press on it, gets over the block. Ahmed has gone cross-court most of the time when he's gone for his big swings. But this time, Tocs has read that nicely, gone in his line of shoulders.
Certainly more than any other time he got across the net.
Cherif catching Tocs out of position there, straight away.
Latvia up by one. This is now a test of Qatar's resolve. They're chasing the scoreboard. That's well played. Such a good time to go over on two.
Cherif racing in from service. If they can get that ball nice and high. Just has to wait for it to come across, and then Cherif has got one block when he's come in there, but he's blocking quite flat and away from the net.
Oh, that's brilliant. All right, are you in my way? All right, I'll just step around you and then come back out wide to have the swing.
And then I'll just place it nice and delicately down the line.
We go to the technical timeout. It is evenly poised in the second set. Latvia with a slight advantage. One thing that Latvia has shown throughout this tournament is their ability just to hang in there, to keep trading points, to look pretty much disinterested the whole time, flying under the radar, and suddenly, before you know it, they've taken a set and then they've taken the match.
They've qualified here in the Olympics through the hard way, and they're not going to give up. That's one thing that happens with Martin Plavins as well. He fights to the very end.
Good read that by Ahmed.
Nine!
Oh, an even better swing. Well, I think that's out, so there's going to be a challenge coming. And then a little bit of psychology. Yes, I think you're fine, guys. It's out by 10 centimetres. It might well be. I don't know if that's 10 centimetres, but... Well, maybe, oh, I think he's absolutely right. Look, oh, maybe 9.5. What a great call. And a great challenge.
Absolutely great challenge. Plavins had the best view there, watching that ball just sail over his shoulder. Great challenge to have.
Might be a keep their lead. That's well played. The pokey just over the top of the block. No chance at all for Plavins to get after that.
Ahmed mixing it up as well on these attacks. So he's done a couple of them early on at the start of this set, then started over his shoulder up. As you see, Plavins far deep in the corner, and there he gets his spaghetti strainer fingers, is that what you called it?
The spaghetti separator,
the knuckles,
yes.
The pokey.
You have to be careful. That used to be done a lot, actually. And what players were doing is they were going with an open hand and then making it look as if they were poking it, but actually tipping the ball over. So the referee will be monitoring that very carefully for those pokies where the players use that style. This is really good now, Latvia.
Good swing out wide.
A two-point advantage.
Fox just taking the pace off it.
Line or hit it really hard cross court.
There's not enough time for Cherif, I think, to say that once he's set the ball up and has a quick look. There's a lot of trust in his partner that he knows he can do that one as well. It's available for him. You play to this level and you're in three finals out of three coming into this competition. You know you're in top form as well.
That's a good touch. Oh, that one's been bullied over.
That net tape taking out all of the power. Unfortunate for Latvia, but great second ball up from Cherif off his own block.
Great touch. It's still in play. Oh, what a block from Cherif! What a point for Latvia! For Qatar, rather. Latvia be devastated. They haven't won that one.
Tocs was so focused on that ball, he didn't see Cherif there, and he was just waiting to pounce. Air time by Ahmed, doing what he does best. And then that finishing block all over it.
Frustration for Latvia, the delight for Qatar. They've turned this set around. That one's not coming back.
This Latvian team only been together since 2017. Tocs got asked by Plavins if he had joined forces. He was considering actually his future in beach volleyball at that point. And so then Tocs said, right, gave up his job, used all his savings. They then won the gold medal in Hague. And it's been success after success. High finishes for the team from Latvia as they've got qualified here for the Tokyo Olympic Games.
14 all. Qatar siding out to go in front. Which they do easily through Ahmed. The tactic of going after Cherif in set one didn't work. They've been going after Ahmed here in set two, and it has been working, but now he is in full flow, and it's looking ominous.
Yeah, Tocs on that block, moving across, taking the cross court, just opening up the area for Ahmed to swing through.
You okay? Well played. Plavins going over on two. They have to do that. They're going to take those opportunities to try and have a swing against it. A block that's not set, with Cherif still trying to get there. And Qatar do the same.
Cherif and Ahmed just play such an exciting brand of beach volleyball. There's so many teams out there. These are the number three seeds. We've got the top three seeds competing for both gold and bronze medals as well in this competition.
Great block. What a block from Cherif.
Lines himself up with Tocs beautifully well. Holds that shape. There we see. Reads where he's going to go. Gets in line with his shoulders. His arms just extending and pressing over. 30 kill blocks in this competition so far.
He's done it again. Once he gets out of the eye line, you don't know where he's going to come up, because he showed he was slightly in front to the cross court. He's got out of the eye line and he's come back up on the line.
He's watched the hand of Tocs. Tocs showing early where he's going to go. Straighten his shoulders as well. It's not just a case of just jumping and putting your hands up there. There's quite a science to this blocking.
Great break. Chance for 19-15 taken. Qatar on the verge here of victory. They only need two more points.
Phenomenal play again from Cherif. That left hand of a whip coming through the ball.
Well played. Got the side out. That was getting perilously close to Cherif's block, but Tocs deals with it. Side switch for both teams.
Given the fact he's been blocked out a few times there, just to have his shoulders come across, you see his hand shape around the right-hand side of the ball there. Cherif just testing out his one-handed block there as well.
Change it, gone back to Cherif. And that's worked. Unforced error from him. Cheeky little point for Latvia. Something for Qatar to think about now. But quite rightly, they call the timeout. No coaches allowed beach volleyball. They have to sit and watch, like the rest of us.
Now let's think like 0-0, huh? We go. Now it's 0-0.
Qatar are on the verge of greatness here. Latvia are on the verge, perhaps, of a comeback.
I've been leading, guys. Yeah.
It's going to take something Herculean, you feel now, given where Qatar find themselves. One side out, and they will have a match point opportunity. Swing from Ahmed, and that hug tells you what you need to know. It's now match point for Qatar. They know it. They want this. Latvia have to side it out. They just have to.
Leading.
And they have done. Well, that's cool and calm under pressure.
When needed, Plavins just having that whereabouts to have a quick look. Going deep to the corner.
Two side-out opportunities for Qatar. Ahmed with a swing for bronze, and he's done it, and now they can celebrate. What a performance by Qatar. It may be raining here on centre court, but it is not going to dampen the spirits of Qatar. They've got themselves a bronze medal.
Incredible performance. What a pair they are. So well deserved. Taking out Plavins and Tocs by 2-0. And that emotion shows you what it means to this pair.
It is a dream come true for these two. They dare to dream, they dare to believe. And now they have a bronze medal at Olympic Games. 21-12, 21-18. Oh, the emotion for Cherif. It's all flooding out. You have to feel sorry for Latvia. You always have to feel sorry for the losers, but there has to be one. And on this occasion, it's Plavins and Tocs.
When Plavins and Tocs reflect back on this, they'll be happy with their performances, the victories they've had. But for the boys, growing up in Senegal and Gambia, moving over to Dakar with the dream of a medal at the Olympic Games has always been on their radar.
It is a special, special moment for these two. They were going for gold, they harboured ambitions of that, but goodness me, they are absolutely thrilled to have taken a bronze medal. This is how it was done. A little pokey of perfection. He was often celebrating before it hit the sand. He knew he'd done it.
Love that smile, love it.
We talk about the stats. It's the top line, that's all that matters. 2-0 as far as Cherif and Ahmed are concerned. Plavins and Tocs played their part in what was an exceptional game. But it's Cherif and Ahmed who have come out on top. One medal match decided. One more medal match to be decided. Cherif and Ahmed, the first on the podium, with their bronze medals. The men's bronze medal match for the beach volleyball event in Tokyo was won between Latvia and Qatar. Qatar, the number 3 seeds against the number 14 seeds of Latvia, and it was Qatar who got off to a really good start. They managed to get a healthy lead, and despite the best efforts of Plavins and Tocs, they were unable to get it back or get into the game. Qatar just too good in defence, too good at the net blocking. Points for Latvia were few and far between. In the end, it was an ace serve to wrap up the first set, 21-12. Into the second set, and it was a change of tactics for Latvia. They were serving Ahmed instead of Cherif, and that was proving to be very successful as the game was going point for point. But then there was a turning point, and Cherif made a huge block to put Qatar in front. And from there, they didn't look back. One side-out chance for bronze, taken by Ahmed with the pokey. And Qatar were often celebrating. The debutants at the Olympic Games here in Tokyo walking away with a bronze medal. It's time for the victory ceremony here at Shiokaze Park. It has been a truly magnificent beach volleyball event from the men's tournament. We have our three teams who have made it to the podium, their flags now being attached to the poles in readiness for the ceremony itself. And incredibly, we have almost an unprecedented scenario of bronze going to this team seeded 3, silver going to the team seeded 2, and gold to the number 1 seeds. Qatar taking the bronze, the Russian Olympic Committee team taking silver, Norway taking the gold. And right on cue, the sun coming out in readiness for this victory ceremony. What's impressed you most about this event?
The quality of the men's competition all the way through. There hasn't really been a clear leader all the way through. We've had upsets in the pool stages, shocks in the knockout rounds, and then we've had two fantastic medal matches that has led us to a bronze, silver, and gold for the top three in the world.
Presentation party have made their way out onto the sand.
La cérémonie des vainqueurs du beach volley homme.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for the beach volleyball.
皆様、ただいまよりビーチバレーの表彰式を行います。
Veuillez accueillir les médaillés.
Please welcome the medalists.
メダリストをお迎えください。
Qatar are keen to get on the podium, and Moles is saying, wait, you'll get in a minute.
Medal no zoteh wa.
Madame Christine Kloster-Aasen, membre du Comité International Olympique Norvège.
International Olympic Committee member from Norway.
IOC in Norway.
Accompagné par.
Accompanied by.
続きまして.
Monsieur Harry Grassa, président de la Fédération Internationale de Volleyball, Brésil.
President, International Volleyball Federation, Brazil.
国際バレーボール連盟会長、ブラジル。
This is Christine Kloster-Aasen, the IOC member, and Mr. Ari Grasa, the FIVB president. The
bronze medalist, Qatar.
Presentation party, and now it will be Qatar who can step onto the podium. Cherif, Yunusi, and Ahmed Tijan played exceptionally well throughout this tournament. And this, their reward, bronze medals.
What a story that is for these two young gentlemen. Their dream has been achieved.
Congratulations, Cherif and Ahmed, bronze medalists from the beach volleyball.
Silver medalist, Russian Olympic Committee.
銀メダリスト、ロシアオリンピック委員会。
Vyacheslav Krasilnikov and Oleg Stoyanovsky.
Krasilnikov and Stoyanovsky played their part in a memorable final. And their reward, silver medals. Another to be up on the podium.
Stoyanovsky moving from the Youth Olympics and now on the podium here in Tokyo.
Congratulations, Krasilnikov and Stoyanovsky, men's beach volleyball silver medalists.
Médaille d'or et champions olympiques Norvège.
Gold medalists and Olympic champions, Norway.
金メダリスト、オリンピックチャンピオン、
That's the step that they have been dreaming about their entire careers. Moll and Sorum of Norway, the number one seeds, lived up to the billing, and now they get to present each other with their gold medals. What a moment, what a performance. What a team.
perfect ending to a four-year cycle on the tour for the Volley Vikings.
Congratulations to Anders Marl and Christian Sorum. The gold medalists from the men's beach volleyball event here at Tokyo 2020.
Mesdames et messieurs, l'hymne de la Norvège.
Time for the national anthem.
Ladies and gentlemen, the national anthem of Norway.
皆様、ノルウェー国歌の演奏です。
Confirmation of
Mesdames
our winners.
Les médaillés olympiques.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Olympic medalists.
皆様、オリンピックメダリストです。
Congratulations to all three teams. They've given it their all. They've played their very best beach volleyball. Not only Olympians, but medalists. Say we wouldn't see these teams here again in Paris, still very young, still with opportunities. But right now, it's all about these three teams, their special performances here in Tokyo 2020 that have given them their medals. Selfie, anyone? It's got to go, so yeah, it's got to be Stoyanovsky. He's got the longest arms, so they can all get in. Brilliant. What a moment.
That just shows the camaraderie there is on the beach volleyball circuit. 24 teams here competing, 54 matches completed. Those three teams there on top of the tables.
Teams will now move around the court for the various groups of photographers. Broad, broad smiles beneath those masks, that's for sure. Indeed, some very broad smiles. Yes, photobomb! team from Qatar, the two of the loveliest and most endearing players you could wish to meet. They've got time for everybody and everyone. So respectful. And so too, really, I mean, you could say the same for both the other teams. Volleyball is a worldwide family, and wherever they go, they always make other people feel welcome. They're always endearing. There's no airs and graces. It's happy to talk to anyone, happy to be a part of whatever's going on. And all three of these teams just realizing a dream. Talk about having a pinch yourself moment, particularly for these two.
How many times they've had medals placed around their necks that have been gold? 13 times since 2018, all around the world. This is the one they've wanted, had to wait extra time for.
One that most definitely means the most to them.
Okay.